Hey guys, hello and welcome. And today we will talk about the insects and arachnids in this video. As in the past video, we talked about the flower reproduction, and this is the part 4, I think, where we will talk about these insects and arachnids. So there are the more species of insects than any other creature. Insects have the more number of species, not the plants, not the animals, but the insects. This incredible diversity, nearly all insects share common features. All are invertebrates and creatures without backbones. Invertebrate is that creature don't have the backbones. So, and they have a hard outer covering called an exoskeleton, which support their bodies with the segmented into three parts, that head, thorax and abdomen. And insects have six joints legs. That's the interesting part, that they have a very interesting six legs, and most insects have wings. Although wings are very common, although some of such as silverfish don't have, and arachnids have an abdomen, head, thorax and eight legs. So they have the eight legs, arachnids. So after meeting a female butterfly, will lay eggs on a leaf. So butterfly lay eggs on a leaf, and then they start the larva start I mean the egg start eating. A critical swallowtail butterfly larva is a caterpillar that feeds on leaves. So here it is the caterpillar's spine, a cocoon of thread around itself called chrysalis. After about 24 hours, an adult butterfly emerges from the chrysalis. Wow. So metamorphosis. Many insects lay eggs that go through dramatic stages of development, and I saw lots of videos, fast forwarding videos, where I see how it transform and how it take from one egg to become a butterfly, full butterfly. That's a very dramatic, as it says, stages. So known as a metamorphosis, before becoming adults, butterflies and bees are among those insects that hatch from eggs to as a larva, and once reaching full size, the larva enter a pupating stage instead of protective structure, during which their bodies are broken down and then reassemble to emerge as adult. They have a lots of interesting stuff. Butterflies and moths. Butterflies such as the with a white admiral are usually active during the day. They have large flat wings and long tubular mouth part with which they feed on nectar. Moths are similar as butterfly but tend to be most active at night and rest of with their wings open, raise their wing opens rather than close. There are more than 150,000 species of butterfly and moth. Wow. And here is that wings and compound eye. Okay. Who are you? You are a fly. So true fly include house fly, grand mosquitoes, and cannon flies. They are insects that have just one pair of wings, with their second rear pair reduced to knob like structure and called helters, and the helters help them to balance during flight. And fly are among the fastest and most maneuverable insects. In flight, they have compound eye that contain many lenses and which give external and accurate 3D vision. So they have a 3D accurate vision and they maneuver more faster than anything. Here is the ant. As we all know, ants can carry more 10 times weights than their body. So ants form specialized colonies contain just one or a handful of queens. The only females capable of reproduction. And leaf cutter ant colony can contain 8 million members. And leaf cutters ants have powerful vibrating jaw that can slice rapidly through leaves. So, and they can carry leaves material weights 20 times their body weight. So they are the very hardworking animals. Now hemipeter, the group of insects known as true bugs. The hemipeter include aphids, cicadas, and stink bugs, and pondstreckers. Right, they have this is the pondstreckers, and they have sharp mouth parts into pieces, then suck up liquid food such as the spore from plants. And some, like the pondstreckers, are carnivorous and feed on other insects. Here is the beetles. More than 350,000 of species of beetles have been identified, and more than any other type of insects. A beetle's front wings, called elytra, are hardened and can be closed over the top of the abdomen, protecting the rear prior pair of wings. The biggest species of beetle is the South American longhorn, which can grow up to 6 feet in length. 6 feet, like a human. Okay, so big they are. And here is the bees and wasps. So bees and wasps are related to ants. Bees pollinate large number of flowering plants. As they feed on nectar, wasps feed their young one insects. Only female bees and wasps have powerful sting that as the tips of their abdomens. Many species of wasps and most bees are social and living in a large nest or hives. Orthopedia. Okay, who you are? Grasshoppers, crickets, and katydids and locust are all orthopedia insects. Orthopteria insects form eggs. They undergo incomplete metamorphosis as their larvae are much like adults. Only they lack an adult's two pair of wings. Adults orthoptera can make a distinctive sound by rubbing body parts together. And there are many parts, as it's shown. He is a scorpio, so dangerous. Wow. Scorpio, he is the prince used to hold Perry. And this one is a grasshopper's communication by. So scorpions are the type of arachnid. Their body features two large pincer, and at that rear segmented tail. Their tail have a stringer supply with venom by two sacs. So here is that stinger used to paralyze or kill prey. It's a very dangerous. And scorpion mostly live in a warm and dry tropical region and are natural hunting at night for insects and spiders as their prey. So they are the so dangerous look like, but not so. Here is the spider. Spider is like a scorpion. Spiders are arachnids and they have 8 legs, each with 7 joints, parts and more than 30 muscles. Their bodies are divided into an abdomen and a head and thorax fused together, so which contain the spider brain and stomach. And spiders are carnivorous and most like their peers with venom, so they have also the venom too. So this is about what we talk today about this venom part, this arachnid and insects part. And I'm not good at this because of I have hardly read them, so maybe in the next time I could do something more better, or let's see in the next part. And see you, thanks for watching. And in the next part what we'll do, let me also introduce you. So this is that stuff, amphibians and reptiles. So we'll talk about the crocodile, snakes, frogs and lots of stuff. So keep with us and thanks for watching again.